Hey y'all, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Mogi Beth. Y'all, the month of February, this past month, I had the most profitable and highest sales total month of my entire reselling career. I mentioned that on Instagram, and I also took a week off to go on vacation in Mexico during the month of February. So I decided, okay, it's time. I've been wanting to do this for a very long time, talk about my numbers on YouTube, because I talk about a lot of different things in generalities, but I want to start telling y'all what my sales numbers are, and I also want to start calling my shot. I want to start telling you what I expect to make in the next month so that we can be accountability partners and grow together, because I am so hungry for growth right now. To be completely honest, after I moved to Portland, my sales were actually fairly stagnant. And after experiencing a good amount of growth in 2020, I'm like, all right, I'm ready. I'm ready to really scale this operation. And looking over, you know, my performance over this month, I realize I have a lot of room for growth. And so I wanna start being more transparent with y'all and telling you what sales numbers I'm having, how much I'm listing every month, my average sales price, what brands are doing well. And these are the types of things I wanna talk about in this video. But in case you're just curious, like what am I even talking about? I'm a full-time reseller on primarily on the Poshmark app, but I also am starting to sell on other platforms as well, which I'll talk about. And that just means I get to sell clothing for a living, which is really cool. I love this job. I love this business. I'm really grateful to be in it and to be a part of it. And I hope this video is helpful to y'all. And I hope that we can really honestly grow together and really hold each other accountable, because wouldn't it be an amazing thing if every single month we could say this was my best sales month in the history of my reselling career? That's the dream, right? That's where we're all headed towards. So I'm not content. I'm not complacent. I'm ready to get things growing, get things moving. So, all right, let's get into this video. Oh, I'm nervous. I've never shared my sales numbers, but here we go. We're gonna do it. Okay, so I'm gonna start out with the number that y'all are probably most curious with. What were my total sales for the month of February? Okay, deep breath in, deep breath out. Okay, my total sales for the month of February was $9,173.75. So that was the highest I've ever had, and I was happily surprised. My goal, honestly, was $8,500, and so I surpassed that by a lot. And I was surprised because, of course, February historically has been a difficult month for me, and it's the shortest month of the year, and I was, you know, planning on taking a week off, or not a week off, actually. I did work, but a week of vacation. So yeah, that was great. I later want to talk about why I think it was my best sales month ever, but I want to go over a few other numbers first and go over a few other things first. My average sales price was $50.13. So that's good. It did actually go down in February from January. In January it was $55.58, but you know what? I'm not tied to that number. If I make more money, I make more money. I don't really care how that happens. And then my average days listed. So this is a number that I track in my bookkeeping system. And I know a lot of y'all are curious about how I keep track of my inventory. And if, you know, you want me to do a video on that, let me know in the comments down below. There's a lot of feedback that I actually would love from y'all, and I'll get into that later in the video. But my average days listed. So the average days listed was 132 days for all my items that I sold. But the median is actually a better indicator of this number, just because with the volume that I'm moving, some of the outliers on either side are skewing this number. So the median number was 74. That sounds a little bit better. It sounds a little bit more accurate. So 74 days for my items to sell. The median number, I sold a total of 183 items. And I listed only 106, which for a full-time reseller is frankly unacceptable. So that's something that's definitely gotta change. But those are the numbers I wanted to share with y'all. Looking over it, you know, I'm happy with my sales numbers. I'm actually happy with my average sales price, even though it did go down a little bit. You know, that median number of how many days it takes to sell, I'm pretty okay with that because I sell things for a higher, you know, average sales price. It does take a little bit longer for them to sell, and that's a little over 2 months. Not bad. Not happy at all with how much I listed. Oh, yikes. And then the number of items sold actually went up a substantial amount, so I'm happy about that, and I will go into why I think that is. So the brands that sold well for me, I'm gonna go over the top 12 brands that sold well for me and just kind of list off how many of each I sold and then the average sales price of those brands that I sold. So I sold, my number one performing brand was Anthropologie, which is funny because, you know, I am very selective with Anthropologie, and I did a whole video about that in February. My average sales price though was $43.62, which is actually, in my opinion, pretty high for Anthropologie, and I think that just goes to show that I do have some sort of knowledge when I'm deciphering what Anthropologie to pick up now, just because I've been doing this for 3+ years now and have some sort of understanding of what is going for a higher average sales price. So I was happy with that. I also sold 16 items from Free People, which is a brand that a lot of people don't like to sell, but I do like to sell it, and that was an average sales price of $41.23. So again, I think with both of these brands, actually my top four brands, that I guess are considered mall brands, because right, you see Free People, Anthropologie stores in malls, but that you can still find pieces within those brands that can sell for a higher average sales price for sure. Okay, so the third brand that I sold most of during the month of February was Madewell, and that's no surprise. I do love selling Madewell. I sold 11 items from Madewell, and I made with an average sales price of $42.91. The next was J. Crew. So, you know, it's really funny. Anthropologie, Free People, Madewell, and J. Crew were my top four brands. That's actually been fairly consistent over the last 3 years. And I think that's just because, like most of us, those are the brands that I find most often. And they're also the brands that I, you know, feel very comfortable with, comfortable listing. So as long as I can keep an average sales price up in those brands, I really enjoy selling them. So J. Crew, I sold 8 items. That was a lower average sales price of $35.55. So, which really doesn't surprise me, just because it's getting harder and harder to find items that go for $40 or above in the brand of J. Crew. So it's still possible, but it's becoming more difficult. And my fifth was Lululemon, which was very surprising to me because I don't pick up a lot of Lululemon. And I wish, you know, I didn't calculate it for each brand, but if I calculated the sell-through rate for each brand, I would guess that Lululemon has a really, really fabulous sell-through rate, because I don't pick it up that often and it tends to sell really quickly. So I sold 5 items from Lululemon with an average sales price of $50.40. So that was great. And next was Eileen Fisher. I sold 4 items by Eileen Fisher for an average sales price of $49.25. And Eileen Fisher is another brand that can have a low average sales price if you don't know what you're looking for. So I, again, am much more selective with this brand than I used to be, and I think that's resulting in an average sales price, which I'm happy with. The next was Outdoor Voices, and if you watched my Nordstrom Rack haul, then you saw I picked up a lot of Outdoor Voices. So this doesn't surprise me too much. These were all new Attack, almost all new Attack. I found one in the thrift store that sold. And so I sold 4 of those, and with an average sales price of $44.25. Next was Wild Fox. Sold 4 Wild Fox pieces. I haven't been picking up Wild Fox recently, but last year in 2019, I did pick up a lot of Wild Fox. So that's still selling, but for a lower average sales price of $33. You know, Wild Fox to me is a brand that actually does sell well on eBay and Mercari, but it just doesn't really demand a super high sales price unless you find the right pieces. And these were kind of laggards just because I have had them for so long. So number 9 is a brand I'm loving selling right now and happy it's on this list. It's Veronica Beard. I sold 3 items by Veronica Beard for an average sales price of $173.75. That was definitely, you know, skewed by my highest sale of the month, which I'll go over in a little bit. Love picking up Veronica Beard, and it's a brand that I'm definitely willing to pay up for. It's a brand that I'm consciously and actively seeking out just because it does have a really good sell-through rate and a really good average sales price, and there's just a lot of demand for Veronica Beard on the reseller market. So definitely a brand that if you aren't aware of, do your research on it. If you are aware of it, maybe just make more of an active effort to, you know, get resourceful or creative and where you can find it. Also, number 10 was mother jeans, mother denim, which I went through a period, I guess, in late 2019 where I really wasn't into mother denim and I didn't pick up a lot of it. And then it kind of just had a resurgence for me in the past couple months where I'm like, wow, I really love selling mother denim. It's selling really well. So I sold 3 items in mother denim for an average sales price of $81.42, which I think is great. So yeah, I'm very happy with that. And I definitely am, I'm bullish on mother again, once again. Number 11 was Reformation, which again is another brand I love selling. Sold 3 items by Reformation for an average sales price of $56.92. This is also a brand that I'm actively seeking out regularly. It's hard to find, but when I do find it, I get really happy and it has a really, really great sell-through rate and a really good average sales price. So definitely one that I want to continue picking up. And honestly, in the future, I would love to see this brand higher on the list. And then number 12 was Bowden, which I sold 3 pieces from, and that was an average sales price of $37.62. which is like the 3rd lowest on this list. So the 3 lowest average sales prices were J. Crew, Wild Fox, and Bowden. That doesn't really surprise me. Those three brands just, they don't garner very much money or as much money on the reseller market, but certain pieces of Bowden actually do have a very good sell-through rate. I don't mind picking up things in the $35 price point if they're going to sell quickly. So, you know, I think sometimes Bowden can fit the bill with that. Okay, I hope that was helpful. With the brands, top 12 brands that sold this month, I would like to see more girlfriend denim on this list. I would like to see more Reformation, more Veronica Beer, and more mother jeans. I think those are some brands that I really would like to, you know, up my inventory of in the next couple months. Madewell and Free People, I really do enjoy selling a lot still. I love the styles that they're putting out recently. And Anthropologie too, you know, certain styles certainly I love selling by them. So those are the brands that I really like to focus on because I know them and I think there's a really high demand for them on the reseller market. But again, the brands that didn't make this list are a bunch of, you know, brands that I sold one of that may have performed well, but I just don't find very often. So now I'm going to go over my 3 best sales, my 3 worst sales, you know, in my opinion from this month. I didn't include any that I have previously gone over in past videos, but these definitely represent some lessons that I've learned this month. And then after that, I'm going to go over why I think I did well this month, and then I'm going to go over my goals. So, okay, the 3 best sales from this month. My best sale this month was another one of these Veronica Beer blazers. This is the second one that I've picked up in the past 6 months, and I got it during that Nordstrom Rack haul. If you watched that, it sold on Tradesy for $335. So I was super, super happy about that. It took 86 days to sell, which, you know, is almost 3 months, but this is exactly the type of item that I'm willing to wait 3 months until the right buyer comes along for. So very happy I was patient because I did receive a bunch of offers on Poshmark, you know, in the $150 range. And I countered and just knew that wasn't going to pan out probably. But since I was patient and just knew the value of this item, it did sell, and I'm very, very happy about that. The next sale that I wanted to mention on this list is a Reformation jumpsuit that, if you watched my thrift with me, my last thrift with me, which I'll put up on the screen, I picked that up. I listed it while I was in Mexico. It sold within 1 day while I was in Mexico, and I listed it for $125. I got an offer for $100. And I picked that up at a buy-sell trade store, and it was hanging up on the wall. So just a reminder that to look up if they do that at your consignment store, look at like what they're displaying, and you know, either on the mannequins or on the wall or whatever. I asked for them to take it down, and they took it down. I sold it and made a good money on it. So that is exactly the type of sale I love having. Super quick turnaround, great sales price. Love, love, love the brand, the style, everything. So I love this sale, and if I could replicate it 100 times next month, I would. The last sale on my 3 best list from this month was a Vince dress that I picked up in Phoenix, and I sold it for $148.75, once again on Tradesy. So, and it took 96 days to sell. So again, another story of just being patient, but was super, super happy with this sale as well. I do really like selling Vince. Vince and Theory are two career wear brands that sell really well. And I am contemplating becoming more career wear focused, just because if you think about it, the women who are making money are looking for career wear. So they're willing to spin up more on some really good career pieces as well. And I think Vince and Theory are two brands that if you find recent pieces from, can garner a good average sales price in the reseller market. So, but of course you're gonna come across Vince and Theory often in the thrift store, or like more often than perhaps some of these other brands, because they've been around for a long time and not all styles do well. So I'm super selective with what I pick up within those brands, but they do have the potential of having a high sales price if you know what styles to look out for. So yeah, just something to keep in mind, but you know, there's definitely potential there. Don't write off those brands. And if you're like me, it might be a good idea to look more into career wear brands and pieces. Okay, so the three worst sales. All three of these were retail arbitrage failures. And I wanna share them all with you. Some of them might sound like a broken record because once again, I've talked about some of these failures before. I wanted to talk about these though, just because I bought these when I really didn't know what I was doing with retail arbitrage, and they were costly mistakes. And I just don't want you to jump into retail arbitrage blindly, paying up for, you know, all these different things without having a clear understanding of what sells well. I hope that you learn from my mistakes and you know that there's a potential of things sitting for a long time and you not making any money on, or potentially losing money on these items. There's definitely risk involved with retail arbitrage, and not only the risk of, you know, not making a lot of money, but just the fact that you're out, you know, the amount of money that you spent on these items for all of these were a year plus. So it's just, I get a lot of DMs from y'all saying that you're trying retail arbitrage now, and I think you have to fail in order to learn. Like, that's just part of the process, but definitely walk into it with your eyes open, knowing that, you know, you're taking on more risk with this sourcing strategy. So, okay, I hope that was helpful and not too scary. I don't want to scare y'all off, but you know, I just want to be very transparent in saying that I have lost money with retail arbitrage. I've made many mistakes with retail arbitrage, and here are three worst ones from this month. Okay, so the first is a J. Crew sweater that I bought, or I listed 462 days ago, and it sold for $42.50 on Tradesy. However, on Tradesy and on eBay and on Mercari, I offer free shipping. So with $42.50 after Tradesy's fee, you know, percentage of what they take from that sale and shipping, I basically broke even with this purchase because it was a new Attack J. Crew sweater that I definitely paid up way too much for looking back. And I had been stuck with it for so long because I kept receiving offers on it that were just lower than what I paid. I would make less than what I paid for it, and it was just grueling. And I was just crossing my fingers, hoping someone would basically offer me a break even. If I could go back in time, I would tell Morgan, don't buy that. But you know, I learned my lesson. Just J. Crew sweaters, unless they are especially unique, sought after, cute, I wouldn't necessarily recommend paying up for them. And when I say pay up, I mean, you know, ballpark, I wouldn't pay more than $15 for them. You know, maybe some unique styles are exception to that, but this one I paid way too much for. So the next sale on this list of like retail arbitrage failures is a Rebecca Minkoff purse. I have talked about this retail arbitrage failure ad nauseum. And if you are interested in, you know, what happened there, just watch any of either my retail arbitrage video or my last what sold video. I talked about it there, but I actually lost money on this sale, but I am just ready to recoup some of my investment. So this is a purse that sold for $140, and after Poshmark's fee, I lost money on it. I received this offer and I was just like, you know what? I have been sitting on this. It's been listed for 444 days and I have relisted this as well. And so that's the first time I listed it. It was 444 days ago. So I think I've relisted it twice. So you know what? I'm just gonna let her go. But I still have another one of these. So if you want this purse, it's in my closet and I'll sell it to you for $140 at a loss to me. I've gone over the lesson I've learned from that a lot, but basically I had no idea what I was doing when I purchased these purses and I spent way too much money. The amount of risk I took on versus the amount of knowledge or experience I had in this category or in this brand, it was just off level. Like, I really should have either, you know, started out buying one or two pieces and experimenting with it, or starting out selling this brand, you know, thrifted or from consignment or something. I just had never sold Rebecca Minkoff before and jumped in head first with retail arbitrage. And I think that was just, you know, obviously I made some pretty big mistakes doing that. So, and pretty costly mistakes doing that. So, yep, you won't find me paying up for Rebecca Minkoff anytime soon. So my last retail arbitrage failure was a pair of Saludos from Anthropologie that I purchased retail arbitrage from their website. And both the Rebecca Minkoff and the Anthropologie purchase was an online retail arbitrage situation, which is much more difficult in my opinion. And I've talked about why that is. And these shoes sat for 408 days and I made, I think, a little bit of money off of them. But I paid way too much for these shoes. They are very cute, so I am, you know, happy and proud to have had them in my closet, I guess. But they just didn't make me any money and they sat for a very long time. So, you know, again, I think online retail arbitrage is difficult, especially if you don't know what you're doing. And when I purchased these, I had no idea what I was doing and I just spent way too much money. I was way too excited, way too bullish on retail arbitrage during this period of my life. And I'm still paying for it to this day. So I've talked about this a lot, but just don't jump into retail arbitrage, spend thousands of dollars and get in over your head. At first, ease into it, make calculated decisions, and if you need to review again how to do that, go watch my retail arbitrage video. Okay, so I wanna talk about why I think it is that I had my best sales month in February. And that's really for three reasons. So the first reason that I really think this was the most profitable month, and I think this was the biggest reason, is that I've been cross-listing. So I've cross-listed all of my clothing over to eBay and Tradesy, and I saw, compared to January, I had way higher sales on both of those platforms in the month of February. I've cross-listed a little bit onto Mercari as well. I only had one sale during the month of February on Mercari, but because of this and because you guys requested this video, I'm going to go into my thoughts, pros and cons, the fee structure, etc., of these four platforms next Monday. So Poshmark, Tradesy, eBay, Mercari. I'm gonna go over the differences, the pros and cons of these platforms. And so please let me know in the comments down below, you know, before I make this video, what specifically you wanna know about these four platforms, because I'm definitely going to read the comments and integrate that into this video. I have already had it planned out, but I want to make it as valuable and informational and useful and helpful as possible. So, you know, let me know in the comments down below what you want to see in that video. But this has been really impactful in my sales. As I talked about, two of my best sales were Tradesy sales. I had some really great eBay sales. Brands that had sat for a long time on Poshmark sold really well on these platforms. So I'm still very much learning what sells well on each platform and for what price point. And that will definitely affect my sourcing strategy as I gain more and more experience, which is really exciting. But right now I'm just kind of, you know, experimenting, trying things out, cross-listing as quickly and as frequently as possible. So that was definitely made a massive impact. And if you're interested in cross-listing, definitely look out for that video next Monday. The second reason that I think my sales numbers were great this month is because YouTube, to be quite honest. I did get a lot of comments from y'all, thank you so much, on Poshmark, saying like, oh, I saw this item that you listed in you know, your video. And so that really meant a lot to me. And I think, you know, I'll never be able to really assess how much that impacts my business. because I don't necessarily know where the traffic is coming from. However, based off of comments from y'all, you know, I'm so grateful that you have also chosen not only to watch this video, but to shop my closet. So thank y'all. However, you know, I only listed 100 items this month. So, and y'all saw a fraction of those items that I put up on my YouTube video. So, you know, it's certainly not all coming from YouTube, but it definitely does make an impact. And then the last reason I think I had the best sales month of my reselling career thus far is because I did list a lot in November and December, way more than I have in January or February. And like I said, my median days listed for the items that sold this month were 74. So, you know, 2 months ago I was listing, and now I'm reaping the benefits of that. So that does make me a little bit concerned for, you know, 74 days from now, and I really need to hustle going forward. But I do think that just goes to show you that I think a lot of times we want instant gratification, and since I was busting my butt in November and December, but wasn't seeing necessarily the results right away, it would have been easy for me to maybe slack off, and maybe that is what happened. I don't know. I was just busting my butt through November, December, and now I'm finally starting to see that pay off in a big way. So instant gratification is not necessarily something that you get when you are a reseller. So list. Don't expect things to pay off right away, but then look back 1, 2, 3 months later and see how much, you know, that has impacted your sales. I've got a list a lot in March. And so that is leading into my goals for this month. My goal for March was to make $10,000 in sales. And I think that is, you know, definitely doable. I had a little over 9,000 in February, so it's not a stretch of the imagination to go up to 10,000. However, like I said, I haven't been listing a ton in January or February, so I think I'm going to feel the effects of that this month. So I need to list a lot this month, hopefully be able to compensate for, you know, my slacking in the past few months. So 10,000 sales, hopefully we can celebrate that. That would be my first five-figure sales month, so that's really exciting. And I wanna also mention here that selling 9,000 makes me technically a six-figure seller. So when you hear people say, oh, I'm a six-figure seller, that means their sales numbers are in the six figures, and that's certainly not telling the whole story. I just wanna put that out there. It doesn't tell you how much they're spending on their cost of goods, and I'm not telling you that here, right? It's not telling you how much they're spending on shipping and marketing and whatever. So I'm certainly not content with just saying I'm a six-figure seller and mailing it in. Like, that to me is certainly not good enough. I want to be having six-figure profits, and that is my goal for this year. And the sooner I can get there, the better. So hopefully y'all are gonna hold me accountable to that. So my plan to get $10,000 in sales is to list 17 items Monday through Friday. Today is Tuesday and I only have 7 items to sell, list, so that's not good, but yesterday I did list 17 items. But another way I'm going to be able to do this, which I realize I need sooner rather than later, is to hire an employee. And so I'm working on that tonight because I just cannot. My other goal is to have 3 YouTube videos each week and 3 Instagram posts each week, which take me longer than it should, but I cannot keep up with that and keep up with listing 17 items a day. So I think having an employee will be so invaluable and really help me get to my goal even faster. Of course, that is adding more overhead, so definitely something to keep in mind, you know, moving forward. But if y'all are interested in learning, you know, how I hired an employee or how that goes and what I did to train them or to hire them, you know, let me know in the comments down below. That's something I can definitely keep in mind for the month of April when creating YouTube content. So, okay, y'all, so those were my sales. That is how I performed this month. I know I just hurled a lot of information at you, but I hope it was helpful in some way. I do love breaking down these numbers and taking a look back over each and every month so that I can use that information going forward. Let me know in the comments down below what you want to see in Monday's video. That would be so, so helpful to me, honestly. Cross-listing has had a massive impact on my sales numbers this month, and hopefully it will continue to do so moving forward. I'm just so grateful for y'all to be here, but really, let's hold each other accountable and be a resource to one another. That's my goal with these videos. And really, I'm just so excited and hungry for growth. I can taste, you know, the six-figure profitability. Let's work and grow and make progress together on the channel. I think that's so exciting. So anyway, thank y'all so much for being here. I will see y'all in the next one. Love you so much. Have a very, very productive week. Bye.